So favorite thing about the Ivanti Neurons product for me is flexibility. It's a very dynamic platform, and I rarely have to tell anybody no. I usually have to say yes, but it's going to take us some time, or yes, but it's going to take me a little bit of figuring something out, or yes, but we are dependent on somebody else because it connects outside. But I can't think of a thing that I've had to tell somebody no, we can't figure out how to do it. That's a nice thing because I like being positive about things and it creates a positive energy and it reinforces the brand, right? The brand is a brand of something that can deliver versus something that is constantly an obstacle like many other products are. Paul Higdon, and I'm the Senior Director of Enterprise Applications at ResultsCX. That includes our help desk, our network operations center, and I'm responsible for all of our internal enterprise applications, of which Ivanti is one. So the main driver when Ivanti was originally implemented, the reason for it was compliance. There were audit challenges, and there were no prescribed change controls, and incident management wasn't as mature as it should be, and that was being discovered through some auditing that was being done. So the team looked to Ivanti to solve for that. So when it was originally implemented, it was IT for IT. It has since, over the last 4 years, we have progressed to be an enterprise, true ESM, and a true enterprise service management platform. We now serve every department of the business. There's no division or department of our company that doesn't have some form of touch through the Ivanti product. So we do a lot of integrations with various in other points of touch. So our HCM platform, for example, so we use Dayforce, and inside of Dayforce, when we do an offboarding, I'll start there because offboarding sounds negative, but it really isn't. It's opening an opportunity for another employee to come in and fill, right? But we want to make sure that it's a single touch. So within our HCM, you do the process that HR dictates for the offboarding action, and that's all they have to do. We then, through APIs, connect in, and within Ivanti Neurons, we open tickets for IT to go do the IT work that needs to be done. We have to worry about client connections for our customers, where we have access to their systems. We have to worry about our own equipment and recovering it. We have to make sure that we suspend accounts within our environment. And we have to make sure that we notify people within the organization of their follow-up actions. So instead of this person having to know the entire process and everything that's involved, they only have to know one thing. I, as a people manager, go into our HCM and I update the employee's record with an updated status. That's it, single click. Everything else happens through automation and just service delivery through integrations. But we've just put a dashboard in place that is tracking ticket rework. So how many times does a ticket go directly to the person that resolves it versus how many times it gets touched as it moves around, turfing, as I like to call it, because that's a bad experience for both people. Because as a resolver, but my language is you have a requester and a resolver. The requester takes longer for the request to get done. So we want to shorten that journey for that and for the request itself, and we want to optimize it. So that's data that we're evaluating. We've got, trying to think, somewhere in the neighborhood of $280,000 to $300,000 in savings with the labor reduction through the automations. That's a lot. And then time. So one-minute action 10,000 times is 7 days, 24 hours a day, if you do the math. So my goal is to have 52 of those so that I can recover 1 full year of a 24-hour day employee and not have to pay anybody to do the work and not have to create the kind of stress that's necessary for somebody to be like that. We have a lot of custom applications within our organization, and we were looking at a way to better manage our client profile. So all of the attributes and characteristics about an employee or about a client. And our technical account management group has been doing that, spreadsheets and various things. So we sat down, my administrator and I sat down, and we were like, there's got to be a better way. So we came up with a way of actually storing all of that inside of Ivanti as almost like CIs and attributes of a CI. So now our client is a configurable item to speak ITIL speak, right? So it's a CI. And that client profile is now connected to service requests and incidents and projects that we run through. You know, we run projects through Ivanti also. So if a project's in there, we can then connect automations to that as well. So we have a third-party alert notification system. If you are an account manager assigned to the client profile inside of Ivanti, it automatically adds you to your notification alerts. So now if there's an incident, you automatically get noted. It's all dynamic. So if your role changes 3 months from now and you pick up a different client, you start getting their notifications. If you move off of that, if you start serving a different service as an IT professional, right? If you're one of our developers or our network engineers and you're supporting a service and you're on call, it automatically dynamically does all that. That has been a boon that we did not expect the degree of impact that it was going to have. For me, the next thing I want to look at is the self-healing and the bot technology. The integration with Teams is nice, but we as an organization really restrict our employees from what they can do. It's highly, highly risk averse and very secure. So we have a homegrown chat bot technology that is AI influenced, and we want to talk. So I was talking to Robin and he expressed that there's going to be an API integration with that. I believe it's either out already or just getting ready to come out. So next week we're going to start working on that. That will be a 2025 initiative, is ensuring that our employees have got the ability to interact through their own bot that's already on their desktop and not need to go through the UI. And as much as I appreciate what Ivanti is doing, we're trying to create the unified UI and improving that unified, you know, that UI experience for the employee. I want to avoid it. If I can avoid those extra clicks, I'm glad to do that. And they're in the bot anyway, so why not just allow them to do it that way? That goes back to the flexibility and extendability of the platform. I'm a value buyer. I care less about the dollar on the bottom of the invoice as I do on the amount on the dollar that's on the savings that we get through the implementation execution. So they understand that, you know, my team understands that, and they're really good about helping us do that. And you know, as far as our renewal, it was seamless.